Our today's topic is amoebiasis, and the causative agent of this is Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica, it is a protist, or we can also call it as protozoan or parasite. The word protist means it is an eukaryotic organism that is not an animal, plant or fungus. Protozoan, it means it is a single-celled microscopic animal which is considered to be the subkingdom of kingdom Protista, or we can also call it as parasite as it resides in the intestine of humans. Now this Entamoeba histolytica, it not only infects human beings but it can also infect other animals such as cat, rat, dog, pigs and monkeys, but the most common is human being. Entamoeba histolytica, the meaning of these words, Entamoeba, that is when this amoeba, it resides inside or within the body of organism, then it is called as Entamoeba. Histolytica, histo means tissues, and lytica, it means lysis or destruction. So in amoebiasis, destruction of tissues takes place. The disease caused by this causative agent is called as amoebiasis or amoebic dysentery. Now how this is transmitted? The mode of transmission of Entamoeba histolytica is through feco-oral route. Feco-oral route means, the word feco, it means fecal matter or stools of infected person. Oral means mouth, and this route is called as feco-oral route. How the transmission takes place? When the flies sit on the fecal matter of infected person and then they contaminate the food and water, and when the healthy person, it drinks or eats the contaminated food and water, the transmission takes place. So this is how the transmission of Entamoeba histolytica takes place from infected person to healthy person. The signs and symptoms, the most important and the common symptoms that are found in amoebiasis are, the first one is diarrhea, that is the characteristic of amoebiasis. Diarrhea, it can be about 10 to 12 times. Diarrhea means the passing of loose watery stools, which is more frequent than usual, that is called as diarrhea. Flatulence is nothing but intestinal gas that is passed out. Foul smelling of stools can be seen, and abdominal pain is associated with diarrhea. Hepatomegaly, it is nothing but enlargement of liver. The other symptoms are fever, and in severe cases, blood and mucus is also passed with the stools, and this is called as dysentery. So dysentery is nothing but intestinal inflammation, especially in the colon of intestine, that leads to severe diarrhea with mucus or blood in the stools. What is the diagnosis for this, or how will come to know that the person is infected by the causative agent? In this, there are two types. One is called as intestinal infection. For this, the stool sample is given for microscopic examination. Now, we have heard that for other diseases, the sample that is given for examination is mostly blood and urine. But for amoebiasis, or which is also called as amoebic dysentery, for diagnosis of this, the sample or stool sample is given for microscopic examination. But sometimes it is not only restricted to the intestine, it may also pass to other, or it may also travel through blood to other parts other than intestine, such as liver, lungs, and brain. And this infection or invasion is called as extra-intestinal infection. For diagnosis of this, the tests that are conducted are X-ray, CT scan, and sonography or ultrasound. So, what are the preventive measures that should be taken? Or what is the preventive mode that one must follow to avoid the contamination? The vegetables that we eat, it must be properly washed and cooked, because raw food, it may contain the pathogens. We must wash our hands with soap and hot water. We should drink boiled water or filtered water or chlorinated water. The treatment for this is the tablets such as metronidazole, tinidazole and ornidazole can be, so that the control of amoebiasis can be done. So this is only the symptoms, transmission, prevention, diagnosis and treatment. We also have to study the life cycle of ent amoeba histolytica.